I first learned about the Hawkeye Firefly split camera a few months ago. I was impressed with its huge advanced feature set and thoughtful improvements over the current generation of split FPV cameras. For instance, it uses a large sensor of the size common in action and point-and-shoot cameras, while having a reported 40 millisecond latency. The ability to set a fixed shutter speed means you can reduce jello without resorting to ND filters over the lens. The Hawkeye Split has 1080p/60fps HDMI output that you can use for focusing with a good monitor, or for digital FPV video. It also supports HDR in hardware as well as software. It can correct for fisheye distortion in all resolutions. And it can likewise use its gyro stabilization in all resolutions. It claims to repair damaged video files on the next power-up cycle. And you can set up video and photo capture using hardwired switches, as well as video recording at power on. It supports the newer H.265 protocol for smaller files, as well as standard H.264. And it uses a standard CADC-style replaceable cable. Features like loop recording and time-lapse also let you use it as a spy cam or dash cam, or even build it into your own designs. There are so many features that even Hawkeye missed a few. It has a USB port so you never have to remove your micro SD card again, and you can use up to a 128GB card. And it has a backup battery, so no more bogus date and time stamps on your videos. The thing is, I've been flying only tiny whoops and sin whoops, so I admit I was surprised when my Hawkeye Split arrived and it looked gigantic. It may have a standard sized FPV camera and 30x30 board mounting, but I've never used those before and I guess I just assumed it would be a 20x20 board. There's way too much stuff in this to fit such a small form factor though. Anyway, the good news is this is the first split camera I've seen where the connection cable has proper color coding, so Hawkeye immediately impressed me as a company that can do the little things right. Of course, this also left me with the problem of how to test it, since it doesn't fit into any of my current quads. But then I remembered my non-FPV drone, a Hover Passport that I rarely use. It uses some fairly large brushless motors and 3.5-inch props, so I figured it could lift the Hawkeye, which weighs about 3/4 of an ounce. So I got out some packing tape and just taped it on. It looks messy and no doubt causes terrible jello, but it worked just fine. I was able to capture the electronically stabilized 720p video from the Hover drone for comparison, which you'll see next. After that, enjoy some 2.7K/60fps full screen video directly from the Hawkeye, and particularly check out the fisheye correction.